Alright, we are back with part 4. We are in the caves. Basically, your explorer's kit is your friend. But not in this area. Oops. I wanted the, cowboy. There we go. Now, what you want to do here is keep going up, of course, but you want to stay towards the left side, because there's one part that you will get stuck at if you don't know what you have to do. And this had me stuck for a long time, until I learned how to do it without dying. Hey, this is the part. See those blocks? You'll have a heck of a time shooting them from that side, so get on this side, duck, shoot 4 blocks out, click whatever items you want, I guess, and go through quickly, and you are out. That was basically the hardest part of that part. And boss, I think, is coming up next. Oh, no, wait, not yet. Any day now, we can get past this. Switch back to the explorer's kit. And go downstream. Yes, this is downstream. It actually moves you, see that? So be careful not to... Aw, man. Some of these crystals fly, some of them fall, as you see, so be sure to look out for them. And these make... these spike things make platforms... whoops. To get across the spikes, even though I failed miserably at that. And we are there. Now you want to go up and left. I don't know what the heck these are or what they're doing in a cave. They look like some sort of lasers, but what would they be doing in a cave? Anyway, keep moving. And now here's the boss. Your explorer's kit is probably your best bet. What he does is he likes to jackhammer those crystal blocks or whatever. Whoops. And to make them exposed to the spikes so you fall in them, but don't be tricked. Just keep jumping on his head when he moves past you, and you should be fine. The heck, you just stopped on a blank space. Oops. Getting a little careless here. Aw, oh, really careless. Oh, come on. He's not that hard. Yeah, when he drops blocks from the ceiling, that can create new areas for you to stand on. When he drops crystals, they just break as soon as they hit the ground, so they're useless to you. And we're done. Next area, keep your explorer's kit. Look out for the stuff on the wall. Look kind of like Ammonites from Pokemon, don't they? Which, they're probably based off of a prehistoric creature like Ammonites were. But keep moving, keep... whoa! There's an egg coming behind you, so walk up this. That will knock down the bridge, but we're already past it, so you don't have to bother with it. Next up is the dinosaur boss. Believe it or not, switch to your original Mickey. Yeah, you don't need any powers for this one. In fact, it would be a burden to you not to have original Mickey. I'll show you why in a minute. And he's gonna change bright green. And all you have to do is jump on his head when it pops out. See these green scales? They're your main threat. That's why you need regular Mickey, so you can kind of bowl them all over in one shot by picking them up and throwing them. Kind of like a Koopa shell in Mario. And any day now, he'll show his head. There it is. Oh, and watch out for that breath attack. It doesn't hurt, but it could push you into those green things. It's a pretty long boss fight, but it's much more fun than that dang turtle. You know, those ghosts give you 2 different suits to beat the bosses of the area that are... or the enemies of the area that are haunting their mansion or whatever. I mean, they're supernatural beings. Why can't they take care of them themselves? Instead, they're asking a mouse to do it, and I don't know, it just doesn't make sense. They should have more powers than I do. But instead, they're gigantic ghost wimps. Any day. Aw, come on. should be like one or two more hits. He turned red already. Come on. Oh, of course, as you see, his tail pops up from the left side, but that's not really a threat unless he blows you into it. And we are done. Next one is, I forgot the name, Frozen Plains, was it? Yes it is! Alright. Now I will of course leave you to watch part 5.